and the professionals there. Okay, great. So so what we do is we get started. Just to tell you that, you know, today's session is a more of a, you know, basics about these, you know, when we talk about MS you know, skills or MS Office skills. So today we will be touching about on the presentation, which is the PowerPoint, that, you know, how we can do it better. The second, you know, some about the MS Word, which is there. And the third would be a bit on to the Excel. So this is a kind of introductory, or you can say the basics session, which we'll be covering. So my question to you all is that I'm sure you must have used the presentations and PowerPoint. So what has been your experience? Like, you know, how often you have used PowerPoint? If you know, you can tell me, you can type onto the chat window. So is it like you have used once in a week, even during your engineering days? Like, how, what is the frequency, or do you do it right now in the current organization? Do you use PowerPoints? Do you create presentations to, you know, showcase your maybe topic or research or any project you have done? Okay, so I can see the answer coming as yes.
Yes,
so
sir.
Okay. So yeah, so generally what is the number of the slides which you have in the presentation, but not very often? Okay, so I can see answer as yes. Okay.
Yes.
Yes, okay. So yes, thing is,
sir,
like, what is
in the SC?
Yeah. Yeah, please go ahead, tell me. Yeah. I think Gayatri was.
Sir, in SCB, I have presented. Yes, sir. In SCB, I think so, 1 week back, I have presented like a PPT regarding about where we can implement machine learning in cybersecurity.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so Gayatri, you know, as we, you know, move ahead in the session, will it be possible for you to share your PPT? Maybe, you know, we can look at that version and then also talk about, you know, what tips we can do, maybe how we could have done it better. So, you know, maybe in these some time, if possible, you can pick up that. So can you do that, Gayatri?
Yes, sir. Sure, sir. Yes.
Okay. So what we'll do is, till the time Gayatri, you know, maybe shares her slide, what we can do is we can go through some of these slides first, like, you know, some tips upon that, and then we will look at what Gayatri has created, and then, you know, we can have a kind of a tips to it, maybe what could have been done better, what is exactly better in her slide, like that. So it is going to be a good, you know, that way to know. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, till the time, I think, meanwhile, I'll run some slides here, and, you know, we can have a look at that thing. So this is the first slide. So PowerPoint, you know, some tips are there. First and the foremost, very important for us is that, you know, we need to know the audience. Like, what is it, the, you know, the audience which we are kind of addressing. Now, say, for example, I am right now as a professor in the university. And now, you know, let us say if I get an opportunity to address the students which are in the class 10th in a school, and versus if I get an opportunity to give a presentation to, you know, my management, which is there in university. So, you know, there is definitely going to be the way the presentation is structured, the way the content is to be presented to somebody who's a 15-year-old versus somebody who's like 40-year-old or a 50-year-old. So the thing is, getting to know the audience, you know, is very important. And what is that, you know, is the expectation of the audience from you. So that is, you know, very important. So whatever is your content you are presenting using the PowerPoint, you know, what is the context? Now, say, for example, if the session is on MS skills, and here in the session we start talking about Internet of Technology, you know, then there's a mismatch between what is being delivered and what was asked as a part of, you know, the, from the audience, from the expectation of the audience from the session. So thing is, getting to know the audience, what is the expectation, what is the agenda of the presentation, what is it that you need to present? I mean, that are the thing, you know, which are very important. Now, another tip is there, say, for example, if you are an entrepreneur and making a presentation on to the angel investors. So the presentation should not exceed more than 10 slides. I mean, you are an entrepreneur, so the expectation of the angel investor or the investment companies from you would be, if you are running an organization and if you have to present your idea, you should be able to do it in a very small, you know, crisp manner, which is there. So in just 8 to 10 minutes, your presentation should be over and you should be able to you know, kind of presented to the audience. So that is, you know, what it basically entails like. And when you are, you know, let us say having a 2-hour session or a 3-hour session. So the thing is, there has to be some content which you can kind of show it to the audience. You must be aware of that, you know, even there are 1 month full day sessions conducted on just on, let us say, communication skills, maybe 2-day workshop just on the communication skills, which talks about your email etiquette, which talks about your, you know, verbal communication, which talks about the non-verbal communication and all that. So thing is that, so which means that the training spans almost like 6 hours, which is the delivery, including an, let us say, 2 tea breaks of 15, 20 minutes each, plus a lunch break of 1 hour. So 6 hours is your continuous, you know, kind of delivery, which happens. So in 2 days, you need to develop a content of, which is going to span 12 hours. So thing is, you know, what is the context? What is the length or the duration of your session? What is it that the, you know, the audience, you know, expects? So that is also going to be a part of which is there. Okay. So use the right color scheme, use of videos, images, insert a template design, adding animations and all that. So generally it is considered to be a 6x6 rule, which means you have 6 pointers and 6 words. That's the general, you know, kind of a rule and the format which is there. So images, when you use in your PowerPoint, so you can use JPG, PNG, GIF. So these are the different, you know, formats which can be used in the PowerPoint presentations, you know, which we say. Okay. All right. So moving on to the next. In case, you know, you insert any videos in the PowerPoint, the length of the videos should be short. So that is there depending on your session. So for example, if it is a 1 hour session, you can have a 4-5 minute video, maybe 2 videos, or maximum in case you want to go maybe 3 videos of 4-5 minutes each. So in that 1 hour, 15 minutes should be for your videos, and then 40-45 minutes should be for your presentation, the content. And maybe you can keep the last 5 minutes or 10 minutes for the question and answer. Even the videos used should be add value to the context or the topic. And then you can use the themes. Like here you can see my slide. So this is a kind of a blue layout which is there of this slide. And this is like one of the, you know, favorites one, so I use. So this is the first slide, this is all dark blue in color. The moment you go to the next slide, you can see this is a, like a clean slide, just light on terms of, not very gaudy, just light in terms of color. And the bullet points, these bullets are blue color and black and blue. I mean, that's the theme, you know, of the presentation, which is there. So here it is, like, say, for example, there's a presentation you want to say, you know, you want to talk about and give it. So here you can even clip a photograph, you know, from your MS Paint, which is there. Take a picture, a photograph, you can paste it onto your presentation and, you know, you want to showcase. Let us say you have done a workshop. You want to see, you want to showcase the results or the feedback of that, you know, which is there, the presentation you made or the workshop which happened, and you want to make a PPT of that. So then you can showcase different, you know, the pie charts, the graphs and like that in your PowerPoint presentation. And that can, you know, add value to that particular session. So in terms of, you know, using the font, so the thing is, if you are giving this presentation, you know, to the audience, you will have a projector and like that. So then the thing is, when it is being projected, you know, onto the screen, onto the panel, it should be easy to read, you know, for the audience. So it should not be too small that the last person which is there. And, you know, what you can do is in this thing. Now, say, for example, your presentation is there. And so you can reach to that the room where your presentation is going to be in advance. I mean, assuming that, you know, there are no concurrent sessions, then, you know, you get a chance to kind of test your how much will it look. So you can, you know, put it onto the projector, the laptop, and go to the last, you know, the last seat which is there, or just last, I would say, the last bench in that room, auditorium or that room, and see, can you see this, read the slide clearly? Can you read the fonts clearly? And if you can, which means now it is okay. And if not, then you can, you know, kindly just, you know, change the font size and you can consider it and make it better. So the thing is, if you are, you know, kind of reached to the venue earlier, you can maybe plan it better. So it's always, you know, kind of welcome that, you know, you reach the venue in advance, which is there. Just do the checks which are there. Attach your, you know, this laptop to the projector and see all the cables are working fine. Ensure that, you know, your laptop has the good, you know, battery backup. So even if the light goes out, generally, you know, you'll see that the backups are there available in the auditoriums or your presentation room, it is there. But still you can, you know, use it that you have the best of the infrastructure, because, you know, your presentation is all about you, and then it is that you are presenting that to the entire, you know, audience which is there. So these are the some of the points. In fact, you know, these presentation anyways will be there in the recording, and if you want, I can also share the PPT so that all, you know, pointers will be available to you. So since, you know, we have to cover a bit onto the Word and the Excel, so we will be moving a bit ahead onto the same. Okay. So any questions so far? I mean, if you have, please do ask me. Or else, you know, we go to the next slide. Okay. All right. So use different colors, sizes, you know, for the impact. So depending on, you know, what kind of role you are in, how you have to create an impact. Say, for example, if you are into digital marketing agency, advertising agency. So here, a lot of creativity of your presentation is the way, you know, how you can impress your bosses or managers. If you are into a professional setup, like, you know, banks or companies like where you are. So, you know, a professional, you know, color, the impact is expected. So too much of colors into the presentation may look gaudy. So thing is, use a different, you know, set of one and two color to make it simple and impactful, your presentation. Avoid use of long sentences. Avoid abbreviations and acronyms. So say, for example, you as a student, let us say a subject name you had, TQM, Total Quality Management, and you put that into the slide. So you don't know that whether your audience, everybody knows what is TQM. You know, people may have different bases, their knowledge, meaning of TQM. Somebody may talk about total quality, some may talk about something else. So avoid the abbreviations and acronyms. Unless and until you are a techie and you know that I am addressing my own team and they understand this acronyms and the abbreviations, so then it is okay. But as long as, you know, it is an audience where you are not sure whether they will be able to decode the abbreviation, then better to use the, you know, the full which is there and not the abbreviations or the acronyms. Use the bullet points, again, like a 6x6 rule. Use dark text on a light background. So here, if you can see that, you know, the background is white and the color of the font here is black. So light, you know, background and dark text is, you know, gives the impact, and you can see that, okay, the letters, you can say kind of, you know, coming out. So it's very easy to, you know, read and like that. And do not use capitals. This is again a very, you know, important point, that do not use capital except for the titles. You know, I've seen some presentation whereby, you know, all this text which is written, it's all in the capital letters. So, you know, in the communication, you know, these sessions and the classes, it is said that, you know, if you put all in the upper, you know, caps, it basically means that, you know, you are kind of shouting. So even in the email, if you, the moment you write, you know, hello, how are you, and everything is in a bold, you know, all that upper caps, it is considered to be rude, basically. So we have to be softer aspect. It's a presentation. You have to communicate your message. So thereby, we will focus on, you know, using these kind of the tips which is there. Okay. And do not use more than, you know, four fonts in any one publication. So thing is, let us say if you are using Arial, use all Arial into your presentation. If you're using Helvetica, use the Helvetica. You know, Calibri. So these are different fonts. In fact, the when you are making a presentation, it gives you a lot of options to choose the fonts, you know, which you want to use. So you can, if you find it much more easier to see, you can, you know, kindly look at that and go ahead with that. So again, these are some of the tips. You can just maybe have a look. Use colors and contrast that complement. And also, as you can see that, you know, since I have used a source called as a website called as ncsl.org. So when you are using the content, you know, from a particular website, so it is a due, you know, requirement and as a part of, you know, kind of content, that if you're using a content, then you have to give the source so that you give the due credit to, you know, that particular website, that from where these, you know, content was kind of used for the presentation. So that's always a good practice and considered to be as ethical to, you know, source the code from where you got the content which is there. Okay. So these are the tips which are there. Okay, so we move on ahead. You can just maybe have a look at this. The last slide basically says that, you know, you must have used in your maybe some presentation that, you know, transition, which means that, you know, sometimes this text is flying in from left to right, from right to left, or from top to bottom, or maybe by one these, you know, text is coming in, or the transition which is happening. So thing is, you know, depending on to the audience, and the best way, in fact, I would say, you know, learn from your mentors, learn from your seniors. Look at the way how your mentors and the seniors, they give the presentations. Go to them, ask them, learn from them. What is the way? I think that will be the most practical way, because, you know, anything in which you can learn on the job, there's no other way out, a practical way to learn, you know, those skills which we say on the job. So I think that is one of the best ways which you can. But yes, for learning, you can attend the sessions, you can do your self-learning, you know, the pro courses which are available on various websites like, say, UpGrad, Udemy, and various Byju's, so many, you know, different apps and educational edtech companies, as we say, are available. Coursera, so many are there. So thing is, you can find out the, you know, where you can want to do a course, and you can learn from them. In fact, even LinkedIn provides the learning courses which are available, and, you know, you can also learn from them. So in the today's world, the sources can be money. The only thing is, you know, how you want to basically use that. So different, again, more onto the tips on arranging the images. So, you know, you can have the images to be arranged vertically or horizontally. So what happens is, some people, they put a picture on the left side of the PPT and then they write the content on the right side. So that is also okay. If you have two pictures arranged in a vertical manner and the horizontal text in front of the pictures, so you can, you know, use that which is there. So just a kind of, you know, for this PowerPoint kind of thing, a summarization here, that plan carefully, do your research, know your audience, time your presentation, speak comfortably and clearly, check the spelling and the grammar, and do not read the presentation. You just have to show the points and then talk about the, you know, what is there. Use the wireless mouse or pick up a wired mouse so that you can move around as you speak. You must have seen that, you know, in some presentations, you have a kind of a, you know, that a slide changer, which is a wireless remote available. And as the speaker, you know, moves along the, as we can see on the podium, he can see that, okay, he's presenting the slide, but he can move it around and he can click onto the next slide, and then that is how. So again, a tip here that, you know, you can maybe watch some TEDx sessions and see that the TEDx speaker, you know, just stands onto that some area. Sometimes they get it on a red carpet, which is like a round area, and the speaker just stands straight and moves a bit of hands here and there, just moving, say, 3 to 4 feet, not too much around onto the, you know, the which you have, the which is available, platform which is available. And in some cases, the speaker may move around, like, say, you know, 5-6 feet towards the left side. If the, let us say it's a big auditorium hall and you want to, you know, give the importance to the audience which is there on the left side of the auditorium, so you go towards the left side as you move on the podium, and then you go come to the center and you keep on, you know, facing to the audience, so your face does not, you know, do not turn back in a presentation. So that's again a tip there, because the moment you turn around, you know, your communication link which has been established between you and the audience, you know, that gets snapped, that gets broken. So the best way is, you know, stand around, look around, and you can just, you know, move your hand, this presentation, and you anyways, when you are doing, you know, session like, say, TEDx or any other, so even the speakers, they can have a, they have a visibility on the presentation on the front, so they can see what the point they are, you know, speaking. The way, you know, I am right now, I have a laptop in front of me, and let us say the presentation is on the back, but I can see that this is the presentation I have clicked, and this is the slide which has come. So I can keep on, you know, kindly facing the audience in the front, and then, you know, I can address to them. So that is the best way to, you know, kind of, and as you, you know, move your eyes around to the audience, like you are addressing to the left side, just move your eyes around, look around into the people, look into the center of the auditorium, look in the front, in the middle area, towards the back area. Then again, you move your stance a bit to the right side, and again, you move around. And so that is the way, you know, how you can kind of make it much more when you are making a presentation, you know, to the audience which is there. So that's there, do not turn back. So some of the, you know, important points which had come up here. Okay, so, you know, this was about the from the PowerPoint kind of thing. And now we can, you know, look and see that if you know, Gayatri, if you can share your presentation, let us have a look. Maybe if yes, it's possible, sir. For you to, yes, so you can share your PPT.
Shoot, I cannot find any option. I cannot find any option to share my screen, sir, here.
Okay, on the, you know, the right side, do you see this option which says next to this red button of leave, share content, like Control Shift plus E, it says.
In the middle portion also it was given.
Yeah, they have given like show device settings, show meeting details, enter full screen, keypad. That's it.
No, close share tray, I think, and then go to the desktop window, screen share option.
Open share tray, Gayatri, and then you will find it.
Yeah, I was looking.
Open share tray. Beside that microphone.
I can see a shortcut here also. It says Control plus Shift plus E. So if you know that helps, and you can. So yeah, we can see that. Yes, yeah, it's visible. Yes, good, good. Okay, so let us see your first slide.
That's mine. I think
very, you know, clearly made. Right. To see that, yeah. Yes, so you can see the first slide. Yeah. Okay. All right. So I can see. I think Mossam has shared the slide. Okay. Good. So yeah. Here you can see, let us all, you know, have a look at this slide. So you can see it gives the, you know, the very good impression to the user. It's, I think, very beautifully made. So it's going to talk about the cloud computing. That's going to the topic by Mossam, the presenter. Yeah. And we can see the logo of the, you know, your organization on the bottom side. So, okay.
The thing is, I used the template of the Standard Charter because I have to present you over here, no?
Okay.
That's right.
So yeah, so that's very good. So if you go to the next slide, slide number two. Okay, yeah. So very good. So I think this looks good, that again, you know, you are kind of starting with the basic, like introduction towards that point. And yes, that is there. Yes, so can we go to the next slide, please? Slide number three.
Yeah. It's like the first, what is cloud? And then I see what is cloud computing, and then like some benefits. So I use like cost for this sign and I like different images. Like for speed, I use this sign so that it makes my presentation more impressive, like global scale. So these are the images which I have copy and paste from different.
So this is very
this type of cloud computing.
Absolutely.
And then like I have to define these three types of cloud in a separate way, like benefits, limitations, uses.
Sure.
So it's very in a small way, and which can be easily understandable, like in a bullet
forms. Yeah, this is excellent. You know, as you can see, we were talking about the use of colors. So since you know, when we have to highlight the benefits, we have put in green color. When we are talking about limitations, there's a different point. So limitations in red color and use case as a blue. It, you know, you can easily differentiate that. So I think this is a very good example to, you know, what the points which we had. Very good. So that's excellent. Yeah.
The thing is, I'm not able to explain much because I have a fever.
Okay.
But still, I just want to join this session.
Yes. I do appreciate that and your courage and the, you know, this perseverance which is there. So very good to know that. In fact,
that's
you know,
why
yes. Yes.
I also make like this differences, like sometimes, no, just giving many things on the slide and it's very difficult to understand the differences, like what are the differences between public cloud and private cloud. So it's like it's a very catchy thing. So people get involved in my presentation, like, okay, so things is like that. I use it like this.
Yes.
And then I think different like hybrid cloud is a combination of two things. So I just make like this.
Yes. So very good. In fact, you know, as
I also use
go ahead. Yeah.
I also use it like these things, like what IS providers give, like this. Different colors, so that's
different colors and stages we can see. Friends, yes, excellent. That's I think excellent presentation which has been made, which is very simple, you know, like easy to read, easy to understand, and creating the impact.
I love to make presentation on my colleges also, and that's why I'm a gold medalist in my colleges. Like my teachers always like my presentation. I studied in NIT Mizoram over the year also. So I have a very interest in making presentation. Like I love to make presentation in different way. So I invest my lots of time over there. Like most of the people have invest very few time, very less time.
Okay.
But I love to make a different slides, like, so it was like that, like here, like if some people not gives benefits in a point wise, but sure. I just give like this images so that it makes my presentation more presentable. Like
absolutely spot on. I do appreciate that, and everybody can see very good examples here. I think so. What we discussed in the text, you know, we can see a kind of a live example here exactly, and. Even the difference is, you can see that Mausam has, you know, made two tables, and you know, she has given the color into that so that, you know, it appears that, so difference between VDI and DAAS. So
I think
it's a very good example. Yes, good to see that.
That's it, sir. It's only.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Thank you
for sharing. Very good. Okay, so everybody, so now we can see that, you know, how she has shared it and made it. So thank you for your contribution in today's session. Very good and excellent. Good to know that. And okay, so this was, you know, about the presentation part. And what I'm going to do is, you know, I'm going to talk to next on this MS Word, you know, a bit. And so I'm sure that, you know, as students, you must have used PPT more and words. Yes, so you made many projects in the Word?
Yes.
Okay. So,
especially the project file.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, projects. Yeah, Mausam, you can go ahead, tell me. Yeah.
The project file, na, in during our BTech, we make our project file in MS Word. And some key points which we have to make sure about this, that the font should be same, it should be justified so that it looks good in that project file. It should be justified, and the title should be in the center alignment, and there should be numbering and bullets should be defined in a proper way. Like if subsection was there, then it should be go like beyond, I mean, in the tabular form or in like in a different way. So we make our project
So Mausam, you know, if possible, if you have a sample, you know, we'll see that. Meanwhile, you know, I'll just cover some points and then we can look at that as well. Okay. Just in case you have any kind of project, in case you have.
Very sorry, the thing is, I don't have that thing this system. That's this is fine. my Standard Chartered system, but it was present in my system. So.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, no worries. Okay. That is perfectly fine. And I wish that everybody, you take care of yourself. I think in today's times, you know, I can see a lot of people having the problems and like that. So just stay safe and take care. Okay, so let me just share. So a lot of wishes to everybody. And yes, so let me, you know, share this sample file. So I have created this doc file. So thing is, you know, you will use this kind of a Word file, you know, for giving, you know, some project, making some presentation. So I did some kind of a rough, you know, here before the session. So thing is, you know, you can select a cover page and you can use here the templates here. Let us say you want to make a presentation, you want to type the year here, type the document here. So cover page, a lot of templates are available. So this is one point which I wanted to show. You know, some images are already given, you know, project and like that. And it will give you a very beautiful impact, you know, to the whatever project report you are making. And after this page, you know, which you have, like inserting the cover page in the document. So then, you know, there are various options. Let us say you go to the next page. These were all cover pages. So when you come to the normal here pages, you can, you know, insert a picture. So you can select a picture from, you know, the source which you have, and then you can paste the picture, you know, onto this here. So let us say I want to paste this picture. I clicked on it. I was able to put the image here. Okay. And then I can insert a clip art. So let us say I want to select any kind of images, you know, I can select it here. I want to insert a shape. Let us say I want to make a flow chart. So using this, I can color this flow chart. I can type a text here. So I can type a text here into this, you know, I can increase the font, make a flow chart. So this option is there by, you know, these various shapes. I can, you know, also use this smart art, which is there. So let us go to, like, this is a kind of an image being posted here. So there's a lot which, you know, you can do. So you can image, put a smart art. Let us say you want to select an organizational chart. And here then you can type in the text here. Maybe you want to put a photograph here. So like this, you know, you can use this. And there is various, you know, you can shape fill, color the code, you know, you want to make it blue. You have these options to, you know, kind of do it here. So all this option is available, you know, as you are making this in the word. And then you also have a option of the smart art, like we covered this, so you can make it. Like here, Mausam was talking about, you want to, let us even add more, you can make this, you know, more numbers to it. Like you want to talk about a central theme, and then there are three important links to that theme. So you can use this kind of a diagram, you know, which is there. So depending on to the kind of the, you know, the requirement which you have, so all this, you know, is available. Even you can insert a chart here. This is the text which you create. Now this is like a sample text which has got. So here you can, you know, build up a chart, and basis that you can insert a chart, different, you know, formats which is there. Like here a sample text came in and the kind of a chart is available. So what is the kind of using this text, what kind of a chart which you want? You want it a pie chart, you can create a pie chart and you put it there. So within the word, it a lot of, you know, options are there. And in fact, header and footer, these are the generally used. So you want to type a header into the, you know, document, you click on this, type the header, let us say whatever, test or something, you click again. So this header will be available in all the text. So you can insert a footer. So here you can see I have inserted a footer here, new document and like that. But still, you know, you can insert a footer to the page. And you can select even these options, standard options, page number one, type text, and the moment you click on that, so this page numbers will automatically come. So 11 pages, you know, have been put into this. So you can use that, insert header and the footer. A text box in case, you know, you want to add a text here. While making some, suppose you must have seen some, you know, brochures by companies like say PwC or BCG. So when they make a white paper, in fact, one tip I would give, you know, you go to Google and you just try to download one white paper by these organizations. Let us say of BCG or PwC or Ernst & Young, these companies, and you will see how, you know, they have created the kind of a white paper or a brochure, and you will see an excellent way how the documentation, you know, has been made. In case, you know, you want to insert, like here, this is a bookmark. A bookmark is like, you know, you can insert an image which you want the text to be there in light always in every page. So that was called as a bookmark. So it can be a bookmark name, it can be a, you know, image. So that is what, you know, you can always insert into the your Word document. So this is the page layout. So page color you want to change, you want to make it different colors, you know, you can use whatever way you want to make it better, you know, for the audience. So page color, page borders here, you can give a box, you can give a 3D image, you can click onto that. And you want to give a box, so okay, you click on this. So box will be available. You want to change the page color, you want to make it light. So this is the way, you know, how you can make it. So it gives you, you know, various basically options, you know, to kind of change the colors. And even, you know, it give, when he says click an object here, so you can attach a PDF file, you know, you can attach a Excel file into your Word document itself by using this insert object option. And the moment you will click onto that, you know, the object which you have inserted, maybe a PDF file which is there, maybe an Excel file which is there. So the moment you will insert it into your Word document, and when you click onto that, it will open it up onto the screen. So these are the some of, you know, the options, and the basics I'm sure you would know in terms of the color, the font size, you can increase, you can decrease. In the text, you know, you can make it center, the left, right, or like that. This is the way you can put your bullet points. So various options are there. You want to make the text bulleted and all that. So you can even change the styles here. So different style set, the format which you have in terms of the fonts. So this is the home page. This is the insert options, like picture, table. Even you can insert a table. You want a 2x2, 4x4, just click it here. A table will be made. You can even color the table the way you want it. As we could see in the slide made by Mausam, that, you know, she had made a table, and that table was having different colors, like say one side and the right side. So you can have these different, you know, kind of the options, you know, which are available here. So you can insert the table with the way you want. You can draw the table which is there. So page layout, referencing, review, you can view the way you want, a full screen reading, web layout, outline or a draft. So all that thing, you know, which is available here, and you can click onto that and use this Word document. So again, Word is, you know, something that the moment you start using it, you can click and close the view here. And again, this is the color option, standard colors. You can choose whichever the page you are in or a text you are in or the table you are in. So you can click onto that font or, you know, that thing. And you can even change the color of that, you know, particular table or that, even as we call it, the just one image or that slide. So you can, you know, have that facility in this Word document, which is there. So in terms of design also, so, you know, header, footer, quick parts, clip art, picture. So all these, you know, are options available. So in terms of the layout, some grid lines you want to have, view grid lines of the table. You know, you want to insert above, below, right, split the tables. Okay, how you want to, like say this was one table, I'll just put control Z. So I was able to, you know, split the table or split the cells into, let us say, two rows like that. I want to, let us say, merge the cells. I can select it here and I want to merge the cells. So all these options are, you know, I have selected this and I click on merge the cells. Now all these cells have merged into one. So, you know, various, you know, options are given here, you know, in this the Word file which is there. So this was, you know, the basic about this, the Word part. And you know, as the more you practice, and I say, as I you know, mentioned this tip, so I think this is one of the ways in which, when you look at how the Word document was converted into a PDF and how the presentation was made, so that is, you know, available. In fact, you know, you can kind of select this. And you know, you can click on this word like save as, and the moment you click on a publish a copy, you can convert this Word file into a PDF file, and that is also, you can use it. So PDF will, you know, kind of look good. I mean, so that is the way, you know, how can you can use this one. Okay, so that was, you know, a bit onto this thing. Now I would like to, you know, take this attention towards the Excel format. So I'm going to share the Excel sheet so that we can have some look at the Excel as well. Okay, so you know, this is the Excel. I have put some sample data onto it. So we can see some name of the students here, Akash, Amit, and Saina. And these are the scores which they have got. So thing is, by using this data, you know, obviously you can customize the way you want, you know, this particular sheet. You can make this bold, you can, you know, insert the grid lines onto it. And suppose you want to select this much for the printing, you can select the print area. So let us see if we can make a kind of a chart out of it. So let us, you know, kind of delete it for a moment. So what I've done is I've selected a text here and I want to create a chart, let us say a 2D chart. So I select it from this column here and I click on this. So now this chart, you know, gets generated. And now let us say I want to, and the moment the thing is, here it is coming series 1, series 2, series 3, because, you know, I selected only these numbers. Now let us say I want these names of the students should be there. Okay, so I can select their name and then I can go to this making the chart. Okay, 2D column. So you will see their names have come in here. Okay, and if I, let us say, if I select it all, and let us say we want to test what happens, so we can even, you know, have a look at it. Okay, so these subjects, the name have come, maths, and then, you know, Akash and all, which is there. Okay, so now let us say I want to know the exact amount. So what I'll do is I click on these here. So what I've selected it here, and I right click on this, and then I say add data labels. So the scores have come, you know, for this here. And this is for 8085, which is for Akash, you know, in this color. You can even give some, you know, default colors to it. I select the second one and I click on it and I say add data labels to it. So data label means this label for this data was Amit. So this name, this number will come for Amit. This will come as 68, 75 and the 78. Okay. Because Amit is in the gray color and Akash is in the this light brown color, whatever you can say. And for this, the scores in the yellow color is for Saina. I click on this, I say add data labels, and I can see the scores. So now, you know, this thing which is there, so this I can even copy and paste it onto my the Word document which was there. So say, for example, you are making a PPT, you want to showcase this into your Word document, you can just simply click on this thing, click on copy. go to your Word document or your presentation and you can put it there, you can paste it there. So that is again an advantage. So here we could see we had selected this column, you know, you can select it as a 3D column. So something like if it is, you know, put to be able to put in 3D, this will, it will make it to put in 3D. If not, then it will come in the 2D. So it will depending on to the content, you know, which you have. Now let us say if I want to try it making a pie chart, you know, can I do that? Okay, can I do it? Will it come something like that? No, it is not coming. So which means this data is not kind of representing itself into a kind of a pie chart. This is meant for a kind of representation into a kind of a word. Let us see if I select only three numbers here. Okay. And then I go to this, let us say a pie. Does it come like that? Yes. Because these are three items and it is coming into this. And if I click on and say add data label, so yes, the score will come, the numbers will come. So for, let us see if I select Sina and then I click on into this insert pie chart, you know, for Sina, yes, the number will come and then I can add the scores here. Okay, Sina scored 67 and like this 1, 2, 3, 4. So the different, you know, name which is coming. All right, so this is the way how, you know, we can insert the different data and create out the different charts, bar chart or area chart, the different, you know, you can use the permutations and the combinations which is available in this insert column. And what we could see into the Word or, you know, the Word file, like the clip art, shapes, all these are available here also. So this is all similar here. But the only thing is you can get more options here. You know, this processes a bar chart. As we could see, Mosam had made, you know, a chart whereby, you know, there's a center, there was one thing. And then, you know, there was a kind of, so these are the different options, you know, you can use it. Let us say you click onto this. So a center theme has a particular point and then 1, 2, 3, 4 different pointers, you know, kind of, you can select different options here, change colors, you want to change colors. So the option is that, you know, just there's so much of, I would say the flexibility or the availability of, you know, the options are available just in this Excel. You can create different dynamic colorful layouts in your, you know, presentation if it suits your, the kind of the theme or the text, you know, which you are basically using. So that is the way how which is there. Okay. Okay. So next is that, you know, in terms of numbers. So let us say, you know, you want to create a series. So you type 1, 2 here. Okay. I can maybe let us say put it here 1, 2 and I can just select these two and scroll it down. So I can generate the entire series from here. Let us say I want to create a series of 2, 4, 6, and 8. So again, if I will select it here and I just pull it down, these series will get generated. So it is up to me. I can, you know, use the options of creating the series. Like here, let us say this is a serial number, right? And this is the way I want a spacing or, you know, gap of the different text. You know, I can use that. So this was again one of the sample, like these, you know, columns were created and like that. And so here, you know, you can in fact use, you know, different kind of view different ways in terms of giving this thing to the column, like how you can sort the data basically by, you know, giving this conditional formatting we call. So you click on this, let us say if you want greater than, let us say 4 to all be in the this green color. So I click on OK. So anything which is 5 and above 5 will be in green color. So this is called as conditional, you know, color formatting. So you can use it here. Let us say even you want to use a color scale, which is there, or let us say between option. So you want to say, let's say between 5 to say 10 here. It should be in green fill with dark green text. I click on OK. So range between 5 to 10, you will see. I mean, that is there in the green and to the light color here, which will come. So you can use this thing to, you know, kind of make your presentation much more creative, and even for filtering the data, like you want to create a presentation less than, okay, so the moment, let us say if I say less than, let us say put it fair 5, and I want it all to be yellow fill. So less than 5, now you can see it has turned the color into this yellow. Anything which is above 5, which is 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, all this has been into the green color because we had selected the green color, you know, which is there. So this, you know, option is called as a conditional formatting, greater than. So this all, you know, you can during your, when you get some time, free time, you can kind of, you know, play around with it, less than, between, equal to, text that contains this condition and all that. So different, you know, ways you can kind of, you know, create and try to, you know, learn from it in terms of using this conditional formatting, data formatting, different scales, different colors. So by default, these colors are coming up, scales are coming up. You can see as we move to 32 coming in green color. So it's all about that, you know, you can kind of use it and see to your benefit that how you can do it. Say top 10 items, okay, you click on that, see what happens, is any changes which are coming up, okay. You look at the, okay, text that contains something, is it equal to, so, you know, text that are equal to, let us say the number as 5, so I click on this, so all remaining with the 5, you can see this has become light color in the pink color. So all this, you know, becomes the conditional, you know, the formatting to the text, you know, which you have basically. And yet, when you have, you know, these numbers, so again, like, you know, filtration is option here. So you can add a filter, say smallest to the largest. This is anyways, you know, kind of filtered here. 1 to 15 is there. So here is again a selection. So you can just say auto sum. Let us say if you want to sum this thing, you click on the auto sum. So here in the bottom, the sum, you know, will be coming up here. So by this is the number which you can use it for, you know, totaling up the numbers whenever, you know, you want to use it. So fill, auto sum, clear, you want to clear it, clear all, you know, you select some option, you say clear, clear all, the text will go away. So it is more like, you know, kind of when you start using the different, you know, options available onto this, you know, the Excel thing, you will be able to get to know more. And I would say that, you know, it depends on to your usage. So say, for example, you know, in your presentation or the kind of role which you are in, if you have to, the need to create, you know, these kind of templates in terms of data and all that, then definitely automatically, you know, as you start using it, you will get to know that. This I'm sure you know it very easily, bold, italics, and, you know, underline options which are here. So double underline, font size you can increase here, you can decrease using this, you know, option which is there. And wrap text is generally there. So let us say if there's a kind of text, you know, you type it here and now you kind of select this and say wrap text. So it will just wrap it up and, you know, much make it much more presentable, which is there. Now let us say on this particular text, just a sample text which you have typed in. So let us say this was on a 20 font. Now you want to convert this second option to be equivalent to this one. Go to this format painter, click on this slide and put it here. And the moment it, what was the original format, the second will get turned into that. So that's the format painter option here. And the, you can, you know, kind of use it. And I'm sure in case, you know, you are using it maybe more often. Here, whenever you want to create, you know, the grid lines to all borders, you know, you can create this text. Let us say you want to create it in a way that you want to copy it, this text onto your, you know, this presentation, and you want to highlight something. So you will create some text here, type some text here. You can copy this and, you know, then you can paste it onto that thing. So this is where these, you know, borders come handy. Sometimes, you know, you'd want to kind of use any border. So you can select this all grid lines, just remove this border and no border. So no border will be there. It will become like light in color, but yes, you can see that. So grid lines and all that. So depending on you want to use, these are the some of the basic ones in terms of, you know, when you are having a font text. So just typing a text here. So the way we have put in, and so here, you know, once you are using it, you want to put it into center. So let us say if this text was like this, and the moment I select this one, it will come to the bottom. If I select this, it will go to the top. So I want to put it into center, I want to center the text from both the sides. I want to make it left aligned, right aligned, you know, all that thing, which will be available. And in terms of, you know, the text and all, so you want to use some percentage. So, you know, you can use this, let us say 100%, or you want to convert it into a percentage. So 100, and you say that, okay, this is a percentage. So it will come out. You want to say 20%, you just type it 20 and click on percentage. So, you know, it comes like that. You want to use these signs, you know, in terms of, let us say I type a number here, 10. And so dollars, you know, whatever it is, you want to represent this, it's a $10. So the moment you click on this thing, so automatically dollar sign appears prefixed to the number, and it is to the second places of decimal. You want to use it to the second or third, you can select it from here. If you select the right one, you know, it will just go that, okay, this much. If you select this one, then you can see it is now to two places of a decimal. Three places. So the moment you click on this, you can write it how many places of decimal you want to use it for your presentation, whichever is appropriate. And this is the way you, you can add different Euro, English, and whatever different. So that is your choice. You want to do that Frank or different things. And more accounting formats, then you could look for in terms of Indian rupee and here. So more accounting formats which are there. So here options are there, so many: number, currency, accounting, long date, short date, the time, the percentage. So whatever the way you want to kind of to put it here. So why why does this comes like say all hashes? Because this is a long text. So in case you want to view the text, you have to maybe double click here, or you can simply select it here and pull it here. So you will see, because you have selected a time format as 12 a.m. So this will come. You want to select a fraction format or a currency format. So all these options are available, which are provided by this. Now these two cells are there. I want to merge these two and center. I click on merge and center. So again, this will, merge it and put it there. So we can maybe, let us say, put some one number here, two number here. So two text here. Okay, merging into one cell will keep the uppermost data because it is a number here. So ideally, this should have been a text which is there, which should have been maybe put in. But let us say if it works, this cell contains multiple data values. Merging will keep the. So if I click on OK, it will just take the value of the one cell. So why this was happening is that when we are trying to merge the two cells with the text or the data, whether it is a text or a number, it will keep the data of the first cell only. But if I want to just merge these cells without text, then it will happen. So as you can see, now this text has been merged. So this is one thing which we learned, that we can keep it here. I want to merge these all cells together, merge and center. Now it has created a big text box for me, which is there. So different of merge across, merge cells, unmerge the cells. So now these, all the cells were merged. In case I want to unmerge them, I can unmerge the cells here, and then it will be, kind of available here. In terms of, you want to print this, let us say this sheet, so you can select this much of page and say, this is a selection which you have had. So you want to go to here, print selection. Let us say I type on the control P, and if I click on selection here, so all this which I have selected, I can preview here. And now what I've selected will come onto the preview page, and then I can print it accordingly. Okay, so let me try out here this one. So we click on this, I say selection. So you can see that I had selected these four columns, so it is available. In the page setup, I can kind of select it whether I want it, let us say, horizontally or vertically, the way which I want. Do I want it a landscape version? I click on OK. It will be available in landscape, which means it's like A4 page lying down here. I want it into the portrait version. I can select the portrait version, which originally it was. So it's like so like that. I can close print view. And now if I click on print, your page will get printed the way it is, showing it here in the way it is. Okay. So this is the way, how we can kind of use this. Insert page layout, which is there. And page breaks in between the print area, we can select grid lines, do we want or not. So here, these are the grid lines. If I don't want to view them, I click on here, it will become just white blank, just a white thing, like a text board, which you can say sample here. So it becomes like that. And if I want to see the grid lines, I'll have to click on here, yes, view here, and the grid lines will be available in the light color. But the moment I select insert, we had selected a text, and then we had these borders, so then all these borders will be available. So these are the borders and these were the grid lines. So that is the difference between the grid line and the border. So what we see into the cell, the outer lining is the border, and what we see the cells here, these are the grid lines onto that which is available. Okay, so these are the some of the, and even the formulas are there. So I would urge that once you get time, you can look about this more functions, which are available here, logical functions, text functions, which are available. So not many options, which are available as a formulas also, for your use, which is there. So page layout, the background, the colors with the way we want it, everything will be available through this. Font size, which we wanted, Calibri, Arial, all you can customize effects you want built in Apex the way you want it. Themes even also of the page, do you want this one? Click on Apex becomes Apex. Click on the Office one, it becomes returned to the Office format. So a lot of themes, you know, are available and you can click and, you know, choose it accordingly. Okay, looks like I think for a few seconds it has come into that, you know, gone to that not responding stage. So I think that is there. Okay. Okay, so I have, you know, kind of unshared this. So even if you want these sample ones, you know, I can share it with Deepak here and, you know, these, you know, these sample files and the presentation, which can be, you know, used for your future reference. And I would say that, you know, by sharing of the sample file of the presentation, I think that Mosam was kind of very information and very useful, whereby we could see that, you know, how she had made the presentation. And whatever we could discuss in the, you know, in terms of text of the presentation, it was available. And then, you know, we moved on into the Word and we could see the various options in terms of, you know, adding the images, the, you know, the graphs and the charts which are available, which is there, which we can, you know, use it to the benefit to make our presentation, you know, much more better and presentable to the audience is what, you know, which we saw it today. Okay. So I think I can say that this was there, you know, in the today's session, a bit on, you know, touching the few points in the Excel, a bit introduction onto the DAT, and then on the Word we covered. And in fact, we covered in the initial half an hour was more onto the presentation that, you know, how we can make our PowerPoint presentations much more, you know, impactful and presentable. Okay, so any questions which you have, you know, I'll open the floor here. If you have any questions, please, you know, raise it here into the forum. Okay. So I think okay, so I think Deepak, I think looks like no questions, I think ahead as we see. I mean, I think towards the end, all I can say that, you know, thank you all, you know, for joining in. And in fact, thanks to Deepak. I mean, he has been, you know, kind enough. I mean, I get the opportunity to, you know, be in front of you and kind of share my, you know, this little knowledge which I have. And as you know, this so-called these times which are tough, so I would just, you know, pray and wish that everybody, you know, should stay be safe, and whatever is the situation which we are seeing, I mean, it turns out to be, you know, to be better. We should be, you know, moving on towards making this situation better.